Hello, and welcome to the David H. Koch Hall of Fossils, Deep Time, at the Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History. My name is Michelle Pinsdorf, and I'm a fossil preparator here at the museum. You're probably familiar with paleontology exhibits of ancient fossils and mounted skeletons, but how do we really know these fossil creatures are assembled just right? And how do these fossils get brought from the places they were discovered and into a museum display case? We can explore these questions using one innovative section of our Deep Time exhibit called the Fossil Lab. On exhibit is this skeleton of Stegosaurus stenops, USNM V4934, a dinosaur from the Jurassic period that lived about 155 million years ago and was discovered in 1886 in Colorado. Unlike most other posed skeletons you see in Deep Time, this animal's fossil remains are displayed in situ, or as they were originally buried. This excellently preserved animal was buried whole, with its belly side facing outward. The head and one forelimb are to the right and turned downward. Between the skull and shoulder are many small round shapes. These ossicles, or bony studs anchored in the skin, would have protected the animal's throat in life. Looking further down the body, we see the rib cage, parts of the hind limbs facing downward, and its most famous feature, the large armor plates that extended from the animal's back. Before this fossil was found, scientists were not sure how to interpret these bony plates. Some thought they laid flat along the body like roof shingles, and others thought that the plates ran down the spine in a single row. This fossil showed that the Stegosaurus's armor plates were actually staggered, lining the spine in two rows of alternating plates. Skeletons preserved in articulation, meaning with the bones aligned in their anatomical positions, are exceptionally rare. Most fossils are only found in scattered fragments, and complete skeletons require extensive work to reassemble. This fossil specimen is particularly useful for understanding posture, joint articulation, and other aspects of anatomy. As you can imagine, getting a fossil this large and this precious from its discovery location in Colorado to the museum was no easy task. Excavators carefully carved out the rock around the skeleton to isolate it. Then, the large block of rock containing the skeleton was separated into smaller sections. Each section was removed from the ground, then wrapped in a protective coating of plaster. The sections were packed into crates and transported to Washington, D.C. Next, the fossil would have been unpacked and prepared in a laboratory just like our fossil lab. Here, Smithsonian paleobiology volunteers and staff work on actual specimens from our fossil research collection, the largest in the world. Fossil preparators undertake the slow and delicate process of removing the surrounding matrix, or host rock, from fossil specimens. This is done using a combination of hand tools and air scribes, which use compressed air and a pointed stylus to chip away at rock. Preparators try to reveal as much of a fossil as possible without damaging the fragile and heavy specimens. After preparation, fossils are housed in foam-lined archival trays or in large storage cradles that are custom-made for each specimen. Fossils not on exhibit are organized into drawers inside of large storage cabinets in our behind-the-scenes paleobiology department collection spaces and labs. Researchers use the vast collections for scientific study. These fossils are sometimes loaned to other museums and research institutions for study or temporary display. Scientific illustrators use a microscope with a special attachment called a camera lucida to create detailed drawings of fossils for research publications. These drawings allow researchers who may not be able to come see the fossils in person to know what they look like and to understand their significance. This combination of art and science has been used to convey information about fossil specimens since the start of paleontology as a science. The Fossil Lab isn't active during this tour, but at the museum, this space is busy with fossil preparation activity. Visitors can watch our preparators working on the fossils and see science happening in real time. The preparation work happening in this lab is exactly the same as what occurs in the museum's other fossil preparation spaces and helps us show everyone the intricate work involved with putting these amazing fossils on display. All of these tasks are part of the work we do to care for the Smithsonian paleobiology collections and to better our understanding of life in the past. To learn more about our fossil collections, explore our website or check out our other narrated virtual tours to see more of the Deep Time exhibit.